Hi and welcome to Resource Management. In this video, we're going to talk about resources and resource types. We will start with what it is, how they work together, and how to create them. So let's start with resources. Put simply, resources are anything you need to run your experience. For example, this could be a bus, 52 snowmobiles, 2 boats, 5 Italian speaking guides. Just anything that could restrict how many seats you can sell across your products at any given time slot. Now let's look at what resource types are. Resource types are where you group together the resources that belong together. For example, boats for full day tours, boats for afternoon tours, and boats for private tours. There are two ways that you can go to create resources and resource types in Bokun. The first one would be to go here to experiences and select resource management. The second one is to go to the experience overview, open one of your experiences, go to availability and to resource management here. It does not matter which way you choose. I am going to go here for experiences and to resource management here. So the first thing we do is to create a resource type and then we add the resources to the resource type. So we are select here, create a resource type, and here I give the resource type a name. Just make sure to name it something that you recognize so you know what it is when you have all of your resource types created. For example, I'm going to call this one boats for private tours. Okay, and that's it. You just give it a name. There's nothing else you do with the resource type. It's just to group together the resources. So if you have already created the resources, you can select the resource here, and then you get a drop-down list where you can just add them to the resource type. We haven't, so we default to create new, and now we can create our resources here. So again, make sure the name is something you recognize, like bus MB65 or whatever it would be in your case. So I'm going to do here boat number one, and that boat takes 8 people, so I put 8 in capacity. Capacity is always just how many seats are available in this particular resource. Then I do the plus sign here, I create another boat number 2, this one also has 8 seats available. Then I can create boat number 3, this one is a little bigger, so I give this one 16 seats, and add it here. Now I have created those 3 boats and they are available in this resource type and now it is simply save. Now I come to an overview screen where I can see I have created my type boat for private tours. There are 3 resources in it, which are boat number 1, 2, and 3, and here is the capacity of them. The total capacity is 32, so you know that I have 32 seats available across those 3 boats in my resource type. And this is not yet connected to any particular product. So that is the next step I will take. I will connect it to the product. So I select here, not connected. In case you started this process through your product, you will not get this step here with juicy experience because you are simply in the experience you're working with. But I'm going to choose here Pro Tour Private and hit next here. Here I can select either one or all of my start times. So you also have here an option of selecting all if you have multiple start times. I will select all 3 start times and then I continue to the next page. On this page, I select what allocation rule to use. The allocation rule controls how your bookings are assigned to your resources. For example, automatic orderly means that your resources will be filled up automatically in an order. Bus number 1 first, then bus number 2, then bus number 3, and so forth. Then I can choose here something called sticky. Sticky is very useful for scenarios where you have, for example, 1 or 2 resources, but want to offer multiple experiences at the same time. What sticky does is to allow you to add your 1 Jeep as a resource, link that Jeep to 3 different experiences, and then when a booking comes in for 1 experience, the other 2 close out automatically. And all available seats are assigned to this 1 available departure. Then we have options here which are private, which I'm going to choose in this case since I'm doing my boat for private tours. And for my other start times, I can select either the same allocation policy or choose something different. So I'm going to use the same allocation policy since this is for my private tour. Now I will simply save this. And here I have now connected my boat for private tours with the 3 boats in it. 2-3 start times, 12, 4, and 8 o'clock for the boat tour private. When I want to create more resource types, I can always come back to this screen and simply select a create a resource type here, and then I go back through the same process. If I just need to create more resources, I can go to create resources here and create a resource and add to this list here and then link it to the resource type afterwards. And here I can go in to close out resources for particular dates if that's something I need to do. Now we have covered how to create resources, how to create resource types, and how to link it to products. Thank you.